Hey guys, what's going on? It's MamaBear Vixen back with another video of MamaBear Plays Pixelmon. And today we are starting a Johto series, which will consist of a playthrough. And yeah, as you can see, we've chosen our starter. It's not your typical Johto starters. So here we go. I picked Piplup out of my starters I had left that were completely untrained. And I took an Eevee, trained it, and I spared you the time in the video of watching me do that, because it is a tedious task. But, you know, we got to do it if you want, you know, your stats to be all perfect and right. So let's change our view, and I'll take a look and toss out this puppet for you. I decided to do an egglocke series, and as you see, here are the rules. Rule 1, you'll be given 5 random Pokemon eggs. The 6th Pokemon will be a level 5 Pokemon of your choice. Now, as you see, I didn't get that Pokemon, and that's just because I picked Piplup already. You can only use the 5 Pokemon eggs and a starter to beat the region. Now, see, here's the rule. I picked a starter, it's just not a Johto starter. And that's because I already did that a long time ago. So, here we go. Now, if you want to, see what these Pokemon eggs are, you can by simply just looking at their Eevees. Or just simply, you know, come in here, right-clicking, and look, our first egg is a Sheldon. Now, I'm not going to show you the rest, because I kind of want to see what these all are. And look, my Piplup, it ran away. Let's go find it. Look, it's tiny and micro-sized, and yes, it is bred by me. I did it all. It is 100% IVs. Now, typically, when you come in here, this is not what you start with. This is, you know, worked on, been worked on. But I didn't want to start with my already trained Pokemon that you saw at my party yesterday. I wanted to give you a fresh start and fresh look, so here we go. Let's go over to Professor, oh, it's Professor Elm, not Professor Birch. See, I don't have my regions, you know, correct. Professor Elm. And, you know, here we go. This is where you get the egglocke mode. You click here and you get it. You get all these eggs, and that's cool. You know, that's really, really cool. Now, here is a quest. Now, in this, I've done most of the quests you can get. You do, and see, as you see, I still have a cooldown time, but here's your quest, and you can pick it, you can do it. Now your quest is to go to Mr. Pokemon's house on Math 30 and come back and deliver it, you know, bring back the stuff for him. And so here's a little NPC to train with, and you know, if you look around, let's see, there's no Pokeloot in here. So we don't have to worry about that. Let's see. Let's see what this level of trainer is. And you can only battle this once. Oh, see. Maybe I should get the owner to reset these for me just for the purpose of this video. Eh? Gravy? How about it? Maybe. You know, he watches my videos. Maybe he'll be nice and give this new YouTuber a fresh start on Johto. But here, look. If you come upstairs into the lab, if you come upstairs, look, here's your Pokemon loot. And I've already claimed it. So you're probably going to find that a lot of the NPCs around here I've already done, which, you know, that's okay. That's okay. We're going to fresh start, and if I have to, I'll just use the Pokemon themselves to train off of. And you see, look, one of our eggs is already working on hatching. It's cracking. And look, here's another NPC. See, if this is a one-time train. Yep, it's a one-time train. And if you come over here, here's another loot. That's already been claimed. If you come upstairs, maybe there's another one. Ah, yeah, look. Here's another one. That's been claimed too. Now, I've done a lot of work in these regions, so a lot of this stuff is all claimed, all done. And I can't do some of this again. If you come here across this bridge, there's Pokeloot inside. There's one there. And, you know, seeing as how we can only use the Pokemon in our party, let's go ahead and put away the Pokeballs I had, because I wasn't sure if I could get this, you know, get the eggs again. So, here we go. Let's see. I can, yeah, we can battle this. Look, it's a Totodile with my Piplup. So, let's do this. Now, I do have a good jump from the Eevee training that I did, so it's not all, you know, level 5. But, you know, you can't, you know, some of you, when you start this, you're gonna maybe already have trained Pokemon to come in with. And just one shot and quickly run through this. But as I said, for the purpose of this video, I give you a fresh start. I gave myself a fresh start and give you guys the fresh look. Now look, here is a bunch of Pokemon. A bunch of bug Pokemon. Hoot hoot. Look, a Magikarp. A Magikarp fish out of water. Funny, huh? And it's not dead. It looks dead. And let's try this trainer. I don't make a bad in this trainer. Cool. Now, for this particular video, this first video, we might only just go up to the first city, which is Violet City. The first gym city, I should say. That's, you know, the first gym city is Violet City. And we're going to only go up to that today. I don't know if we'll battle the gym leader, you know, the gym trainers, gym leaders. I'm going to save for a video for tomorrow. But for now, this we're going to make our way to it. And we're not going to fly. We're not going to fly around. It's going to be all legitimately done. You know? Now look, we got a Pokeball from this trainer, Tristan, right outside the city. So, that's a good place if you want to get a Pokeball. Free Pokeball. There's another loot. Now Gravy first added these new ones. Some of these are new. Oh look, I can get it, that's cool. I did go around and look for these. Maybe some of them I missed. It wouldn't surprise me. You know, just like every other one. Yeah, see, I got that one. Again, as I said in my previous videos, I've said them all, just look around. You'll find all these loots everywhere. And look, we get a great ball from this trainer, Jonathan. And you'll see that, you know, it says level 6, but it's a custom NPC, so the level of the trainer might be wrong. You'll just have to test it and see. And let's see, what's around this? Oh, nothing. There is nothing. Nothing at all. And, you know what? We're going to go on this side before we battle that trainer. And use a healer. We'll use a healer. I'm not going to Pokeheal because some of you are not going to have it. So we'll just, you know, use this. And you can see the Pokeball did not even show up. It's all good, though. And we're gonna battle. That's right. That look, we're beating it. That's cool. That's cool. When we get down this road, eventually, I am not gonna be able to beat it, and that's fine. I like the challenge. I like the fresh start that I'm getting. And did we just go? Oh, we didn't go in a big circle. So that's good. So see, you can see levels are going up steadily, which is good. So when you first start and you have your level 5 starter, whichever you choose, this is a good place to start coming for newbies. And here, see, we've almost reached the first city already. And this is not your first gym city, this is just the first city that you reach in the game, and, you know, on this map, on this server. And we have Cherry Grove City. Now, I showed this to you yesterday, I didn't show you all around it. I just flew past it real quick. But here is this. Now here's this NPC. Now I already battled this because Gravy had me test it. But when you battle this particular NPC, if you're first starting this NPC, you can make money off of. And it's a good amount of money to start with. I think the amount was 5,000. If I remember correctly, it was tested a couple weeks ago. And so when you come when you start in Johto, this trainer, you absolutely want to battle. And as you can see, I already battled it, so I'm done with it. It just made my 12 million look a little bigger. And look, here, when you come to the city, we have a Pokemart. Now, most all of these look the same, so you know which is which. And you can see, here's a Pokeloot. And you guys, let's see. Most of these sell the same thing. Most of these little ones sell the same thing. They'll sell Pokeballs, Great Balls, Ultra Balls, some food. Because you won't have a feed command like I do, so you need the stick and stuff from running around. And then you have your all three of your potions here. And that is a good thing when you're doing this. And if you're doing it legitimately, that's good too. It's kind of cool. And here comes in. Look, another trainer. And that's the battle once, you know, once trainer, that's good. Again, I'm not gonna find every trainer I can battle all the time, and that's it makes it even more of a challenge, right? And in here is another trainer. Ah, look. One of our Pokemon hatched. And we have to nickname it, and it's a Metapod. With shed skin. Which, you know, that's a good thing for, I think. I have no idea. I haven't trained a Metapod yet. So let's see. What should we rename it? What should we rename our Metapod? Let's go with Husk. Because, you know, it's a shell. So we'll go with Husk. And you see two more of our... Oh, look. It's not two more. It's three more of our eggs are starting to crack. That's cool. I'm excited to see what they are. And there's another Pokéloot. And, yeah, I got that one too. And I'm not going to show all of these to you. But in this lake area, you know, in the water area, if you go all around, there's a few of them hidden around here. You see right over there is one. And if you look right over there, there's one. But there are a few more hidden around that you can find. And I don't know if I can battle this trainer again. I think you can battle every day. But you can only turn the quest in once a week. And I'm sorry, I just flew. It happens. You know what? We'll disable it. We'll disable Butterfly Command. There we go. So it won't happen. And yes, you can battle it. So here we go. And, oh, it's a Slowpoke. So this may be a little difficult because water versus water. And, yeah, my Pokemon's asleep. Pokemon's asleep. What's she doing to me, man? Wake up! There we go. You woke up.
Magikarp.
And a Magikarp. This should be no problem. Who can't battle a Magikarp? Magikarp are great Pokemon to train off of if you're first starting. They really, really are. Honestly. They'll get you a good amount, you know, of levels before it becomes useless, really. You know, and we're gonna heal real quick. Oh, nice thing. Pokemon centers. Each city has one of these too. So when you're done with your gym battle, or if you're passing by one of these cities, you know this city, Cherry Grove, you can come in here and heal. Now each of these Poke centers has the PCs, healers, and when we're done, if we turn around, look. You have a chest to store stuff, so if you don't, you know, have a house yet, you can use that. And I believe everyone that starts in gets their first PV unlocked. I'm not positive, but I think that is correct. And look, we've made it to Route 30 already. And see, this route is where you get the Mr. Pokemon quest completed. And you go that way, see? This way to Mr. Pokemon's house. And look, we found another trainer. We're actually moving pretty quickly, so maybe, just maybe, I'll try battling that. We'll try battling the gym leaders. Now, that probably won't go very well. Honestly, it probably won't. And... look, we learned another move, Peck. We learned Peck. Now this moveset that I come up with will probably not be the final moveset of Empoleon because I found one that I liked. I'm going to create a Choice Spect Empoleon. So if you're familiar with training sites, you'll know exactly what I'm about to do with it. And I'm telling you this because I probably won't be using this on my normal team. I don't actually have a normal team. I just train and train. So I could create multiple teams, but for this purpose, we are going to go ahead and delete Growl, because I don't like useless moves like that that just lower stats. And you may like them, you may not find them useless, but all really, movesets are a personal choice, and we're going to show you where Mr. Pokemon's house is. Keep going down this path, you keep winding around this path. You come around here. And look! We are going to Mr. Pokemon's house. And here's another trainer. Battle you. And that's a rat attack. And we're going to use flying move. Peck. Pecky, pecky. And that. Oh, are we going to be stuck in battle? Are we going to be stuck in battle? Are we going to be stuck in this battle? I think we are. Now, if you get stuck in a battle like this, you see this waiting thing. Do not just sit here. Unless sometimes if you sit here it works, but if you do and it doesn't work, it's not working and it doesn't eventually catch up. All you have to do to end that battle is just do /end battle. And that works most of the time. And if it doesn't work, in some cases it will not work. Just go to spawn or go home and it'll end the battle for you. You don't have to relog, you don't have to be kicked. But please, don't just sit on the trainer hoping it'll, you know, move on. Because sometimes it just won't. And if you get stuck on a trainer, you might get kicked out of the game until you realize, oh, I should have been on a trainer. Or waiting. That's not fair to other players who want to do this. It really isn't. And look, we got another great ball. And look, we have 3 Pokemon eggs that are going to hatch any second. And we're going to see what they all are. And here is another trainer. We have Declan, a swimmer trainer. And it's a level 14, so this might be a little bit difficult. So, let's do this. Now, typically when I'm training a Pokemon or training a team, I will have XP shares all over these. So that, you know, they level all at the same time. You don't have to switch back and forth. This is just a hassle, because as you see, we're about to lose this. We really are. And I don't have... Do I have potions? Do I have a potion? Oh, I do. Cool. I was given one by a trainer. I must have been, because I didn't buy one. And I think when we reach Violet City, we'll buy one. We'll buy a couple, because obviously it isn't going to be one shot like I like to do. It's going to be multiple times of moves and moves, and that's fine. Oh, and see, there we go. That was it. Because as Metapod, you're pretty useless Pokemon until you evolve into a Butterfree, and there, I blacked out. And we'll see if Mr. Pokemon has a PC. Or not PC, but a healer. And it does. Look. Healer. Hopefully these 3 Pokemon that are about to hatch will be a little bit more useful than a Metapod. Now, if you are not going to be using an XP share or a Lucky Egg, and you want to train a Pokemon like this, put it up here. And when you're in battle, just switch it out. And that's about, you know, about a month's trainer. So that's fine. And this one once by day? Yeah, once a day trainer. So you just wait for it to reset. And, you know, you can go turn in the Mr. Pokemon quests. And I think, yeah, the back of the professor's lab, it already said I did, so I can't do it again. Let's see if we can do this one. Oh, we can. Collect 5 types of apricorns from Route 30, and this weird trainer, will make you something. Now, let's go around and see if we can find them, and this is what it's going to look like. It's going to be this with a glowstone, and it's going to be Siren with the apricorn in it, and you just right-click it. And you'll see it's specific. It is specific, so you can't just use any apricorn. It has to be these apricorns. They're specially named for this quest. Just like when we get to the granny quest to go to, you know, the Johto League. Those are specific quest items too. You'll see that here eventually. I'm not going to do a tutorial since we're going to do playthrough. I'm not going to do a tutorial on the grandma quest. As I said in my video of yesterday, I'm going to do the actual quest and do through the playthrough. And as you saw, we just found the blue apricorn by Mr. Pokemon's house. And there are 5 of them, and sometimes I do forget where they are. Most of the time, I do find them eventually. And usually the one I've forgotten before. And look, 3 of our Pokemon have hatched. And we'll name those in just a second, right after we do this quest. And if you come over here to the grandma quest, you are going to find another one. You're going to find here is your pink apricorn. And now we're looking for a white and green sign. Actually, the white one is in here. It's over here. No? Wait. Yes, it is. Here's the white one. And we gotta go find the green one. And let's go up here. As you can see, it looks like it was made a little easier. And here is the path down to that one. And here I come. We'll battle that trainer in a minute. As soon as we've named our new Pokemon. And here's the green one. Let's go turn this in. Let's go back to this weird trainer. And we'll turn in this and you'll see what we get. We'll see what we get. Get out of the way, you stupid ladybugs. And here we go, let's turn it in and see what we get. And we get 100 bucks. And we've gotten, as we see, 10 premier balls. Which, if you're like me, they're, you know, they have an effect. They have these, the red particle effect when you toss out the Pokemon. And I kind of enjoy it. It gives it a little different thing. Now, per the rules of egglocke mode, we have to name this. And it's a lightning rod one, so that's kind of cool because, you know, this electric attacks aren't affected by ground, so you're probably not going to be attacked by an electric attack, but you know, you never know. So, since it's the fully evolved form, we'll just name it Whack. Whack, or Wacky. There you go, Wacky. I like Wacky for Marowak. I'm not really good at naming Pokemon. I don't do it all the time. And we have a Chinchou with Volt Absorb, and that's good. Chinchou is actually good. Lantern is actually a good Pokemon to have because it really isn't affected by electric type moves all that much. How do we name it Lanny? There we go, Lanny. And we have a Combusken. Now this is cool. Now in my PC, I have a fully trained Blaziken, 100% IVs, and it is an HA or hidden ability Pokemon. So it has speed boost, but this is cool. Has Ember already, so this will come in handy because, you know, water types aren't good for everything. And what's its gender? Is the gender sometimes? Okay, it's a male. And here we go. What should we name a Combusken? Let's name it Ollie. Because, you know, it's a fighting type. You know, it's a firefighting type. And, you know, Muhammad Ali, good fighter, good boxer. And this will be hatching at any time. It's just started to crack, and we already showed you what it was, you know, for the purposes of figuring that out. Now I'll come back here, and we'll battle this trainer. And then I have some more use for Pokemon, maybe it'll go better. Now we're starting out with a Caterpie battle, so it's a lower level than the other trainer, so it actually should go a lot better, a lot smoother. I did look. As I said, if you want to train a Pokemon, there it is. You trained it. And now people are going to say hi, so let's say hi back. Let's be nice to these people who are saying hi and say hi. Oh, that was a command. My bad. They say hi. Now let's go back and heal. Let's go back and heal this Metapod up, or, you know, Piplup. I don't think Metapod took any actual damage. And we'll be right on our way towards Violet City. There we go. Now, let's level up one of our other Pokemon. Let's level up our Combusken, because this could come in handy. So we'll do this. Oh, we are not at the level for that yet. So we did give it some damage, a little tiny bit of damage. To Hoot Hoot, that's, you know, it's about twice its level. More than twice its level. And there we go. There is our Combusken's jump in level. Now we'll go back. We'll go back and heal. We'll go back and heal. Because who wants dead Pokemon when they're trying to battle? And our Sheldon. Our Sheldon is about to hatch. And you know what? We're actually going to name it Sheldon. Like, actual from, you know, if you watch Big Bang Theory, we can name it Sheldon. As, you know, I just find it amusing. Sheldon and then Sheldon. Same thing. One letter difference. I'm going to take away And here you've come to another pass. This is Route 30. And over here is the dark cave. I'm going to go in here and I'll show you what it is. It's not really a whole lot of anything, really. There's a trainer in here. And some Pookie Loot that I've already gotten. And this is a Magikarp area. And you see in the water over there, there's some Pookie Loot. And there's your Pokemon here. So let's do this. Let's jump our Chinchou. Let's jump Chinchou. We'll battle this level 15. If we get in trouble, well, he's... Oh, we did get in trouble. Yeah. Look, you Magikarp. You were not supposed to do that. But you see that little spawner in there, and it's a Magikarp spawner. But look, and our Piplup, it's evolving, and I'm gonna let it evolve. I'm gonna have Prinplup. You're gonna have a micro-sized Prinplup. Now, typically, when you come onto the server, your starter is gonna be shiny. My starter that I picked was a Charmander, and that Charizard is already completely trained, so I couldn't use it. And look, we learned Metal Claw because we evolved. Now, let's trade and pound for that. Now, we might not keep this as a move because it's a low accuracy move, and I like moves that hit 100% of the time. And yes, you may find that the lower accuracy have more damage, but to me, the accuracy is more important than the damage. Sometimes, if you're more familiar with training, then you know you might choose otherwise. And we're gonna train on this trainer. Oh, it's a once player. It's a player. You know? And there's a Mareep stuck and glitched in. There's another trainer. Here, we can turn off this one. Yes, we can. Look. And we have Peck. And I'll see what Metal Claw does. Metal Claw, ooh, look. Did a good amount of damage to the seconds. That's good. That's good. We all like it. And here's James. With a Caterpie. Oh, he's a flying leaf. He's a bug. When it comes to bugs and things, you gotta be like Misty and run away from them all. I personally found him that funny. And look, our Sheldon evolved. And let's name it our Sheldon. Sheldon. And that nose sturdy and that's a basic move, so that has to be moved up a little. And it's a mild nature. Now let's see what all these other natures are, because I didn't actually look. And it's a careful nature, mild, gentle, timid, serious, and lax. Well, so see, probably not all the natures you would want to use for these particular Pokemon. That's okay. This is just a playthrough. They don't have to be perfect. Not in this. That's the point, right? Of egglocke. To do it from scratch. And we do Metal Claw. This might be a little more difficult. It is a Scyther. Oh, I beat that too. Cool. Now when this reaches Empoleon, I may switch to another Pokemon, one of these other five Pokemon, just to give it a little bit of a start in here. You see, we passed it. Where is it? Here, look. A Violet City. We made it. We made it to Violet City today. And this is all good. This is a cool city. And I'll show you around. Here's your Pokemon Center. As you saw, I just walked in it without even paying attention. Now, when you come to these cities, the gym cities, if you want to come here quickly, and you know, I showed you the Warps page yesterday. Well, when you come here, you have to unlock all these warps to get back to these towns. Now, Cherry Grove doesn't have one. It doesn't have a warp. It doesn't have one at all. You'll have to actually go from New Bark to Cherry or, you know, Violet City back. And for that, you can have a flying Pokemon. Flying over these regions is actually quicker, if you ask me. Even with a Pokemon, even on a Pokemon's back, you can do it. And to unlock the warps is this sign right here. You just unlock it and see. You see it says unlocked Violet City Warp. That is how you get back and stuff. Now, I have something else I didn't show you in the Pokemon Center in Cherry Grove because I didn't pay attention to it. That is a disposal sign. And here, in here, look, you can put it in here, close out, and look, it got rid of it. So any items you don't want, like this, the quest item, I don't need it right now, it's gone. All gone. So you can save them in your under chest if you don't have a house yet. Now, honestly, I recommend, go through these regions that you do already have a house that you can store stuff in, because a lot of the stuff that the feather that I just put in there, you can sell it to the GUI shop. And if you don't want to do it right away and you want to stock up to sell more at a time, I'd recommend having a place to store it. Now, if you come over here, there's a quest. And look, it says click for Bellsprout. Well, if you come in here, you use your bare hands, you talk to Jimmy. He says, I really want a Bellsprout, and they taste so good. If you find a Bellsprout, I'll give you my Onyx. I'll come over here, find a Bellsprout. Please don't give me to Tommy. And look, we got a tree. You got a tree. And turn it in. Oh, looks like I have a cool time. Oh, cool down time. Well, when you turn it in, you actually do get an Onyx. So that's cool. And so, again, this is another thing. It'll just toss it out. I don't need it. And over here, we have another trainer. And we have Pokemon Academy. I'm walking there just a second. We'll battle this trainer because it is not a one-time trainer. We'll use Peck. We'll just spam it with Peck because flying and bug types just seems like a good idea. And look, our Primplup, it learned Bubble Beam. And now, I like to trade out moves like this, Bubble Beam. I like to trade them out for their stronger counterpart. Even though it's less PP, it is still stronger. That is my personal, thing on training. I like to trade up for the stronger moves. And I do that even in the real games, in the actual games themselves. And as I said, I'm not all about the status moves. I like to attack. I'm a full-out attack kind of trainer. Now, anyone who has wanted to battle me in the server has never really gotten to. I'm not really interested in battles all that much, player versus player. But I do it on occasion because I do get bored, and that's when I tend to do it, just for the heck of it. And, I believe that some people are actually afraid to battle me because they know that I train a lot, but honestly, sometimes I think I have actually no clue what I'm doing, and this trainer is also once a day. And, I thought this was a shop, but it's not. It's just potions on signs. And, when I do these battles, it just depends on my mood. A Pokemon I use, typically, I anticipate that people are going to use the most used Pokemon in here, which are your Dragonite, Lucarios, things like that. People use them all the time. They use them constantly. And honestly, I have all of those Pokemon. I have your typical used Pokemon. Now, I have two Dragonite. I have one that's a normal ability, and then I have one that is its HA, which is multi-scale, and they're both trained for their specific ability and specific, benefits. Now over here, we have Bellsprout Tower. We have the Sprout Tower, which is Bellsprout Tower. And if you come over here to the right, you'll see there's another trainer. And I think, a Pokéloot in the corner. And I'll see if we can battle this one. No, it's a Battle Month trainer as well. And Gravy, I know you're going to watch this video when you see it. And I don't know if you can be kind enough to me and help me restart some of these, but that's okay if you don't. I'm actually getting a good amount of XP off of trainers that I can battle. So, I'll leave it up to you. Now, see it like this? If you come in here, Bellsprout, it's Sprout Tower. It's mostly all rest Pokemon. So, we're done with this. I know that they're level 13, but we're going to try using our Combusken, okay? We're going to use our Combusken. Just for the simple fact, it already has Ember as a move. And we all know that grass and fire. Oh, we see, already burned it. And there we go. Now, I will continue to use combustion until it's gone, it's dead, and fainted. Now, I think these trainers, yeah, they reset once a day, so you can battle them. I get XP if you're new. If you're not, you can still use it. It's a big tower. It's actually a maze. I believe it's a maze. You can, you have to go through to get to the top. Oh, look. All this training in the Sprat Tower for our fire type. We have a new fighting move. Now we're going to take Quick Draw. Because Focus Energy can maybe be useful. Oh, we learned Peck at the same time. Well, this is options. We're going to give it a Scratch. It's a low move. And now because there are no healers around here, I'm gonna cave and use Poke Heal. Well, actually, you know what? I said until it's dead, right? Until it's fainted. And we're gonna come up here. And you see there's nothing up here. Yeah, you may find nothing. And that's, you know, maybe the joke. I don't know. And so we have to go back through. Oh, we have to go back downstairs. Back down the ladder. And here's a little secret. If you can't get to the other side, you might be able to overthrow it. And we'll have to go down just a little bit. Oh, we ran into that, but yes, sometimes you can overthrow the fences, which is something new, and I don't want to take the time to find that way around. As let's face it, sometimes we're all lazy at some point, right? I'll come up here. Did I already battle this one? Yeah, I did. So we'll go through this door. Okay, did I just make a quick circle? No, this is a trainer that was on the other side of that. Yeah. Yeah, it is. Let's go up. Let's go up. Up. And we'll go around here. And then, let's battle. Oh, we're in a big circle. Okay. And we have to go back down. Because that's low. And that's fine. That is perfectly fine. I can do this all day long. Unfortunately, you guys won't. You'll get bored. So let's see if we get this right this time. If we don't get it right, we'll go out. And up again. And nothing. There's nothing here. Missing something here. Maybe? Anyways, this is Sprat Tower. You're gonna have fun doing the maze. I am going to leave it. And here we go. Back across the bridge. And what else is around here? Here is the Pokemart, and here is this. Now see, if you come here, it's not food. It's the badge. Yes, you could buy the badges, you could sell the badges, you buy the badges from other people, you could sell them in town, the respective town, I should say. And they all increase per the region you're in. The Kanto badges are 1,000, and I think if you sell the Hoenn badges back into the gyms, it's 2,000, but if you sell them to other people, you can create your own price, and, you know, you can get more. I've gotten a lot more off of home badges and stuff. People actually buy them, and as I said, when we found a Pokemon Center, we're going to buy some of these. Yeah? And you see, look, and the price is here. Look, it's 150, and if you go into the GUI shop, if we spell it right, there we go. It is... Well, it's actually 150, so that's the right price. And some of the stuff, you won't find that it is the same price. In some of the regions' stuff, in some of the shops, you'll find that it's actually lower. Like, you'll come up on TM Shops here soon, and you'll find that I'm going to buy 10. We're not going to buy a lot, but that's that. And you'll find TM Shops, and you'll find that some of those TMs are a lot lower in price than what's in the GUI Shop, because the GUI Shop is 10K. No matter what TM it is, it's 10K, and not every TM is in that GUI Shop. So you may not find the one you're looking for. That's like the other day I was looking for a rain dance TM on my Magnemite. For my Magnemite, because I'm training it that way. And I found out that if you go, I don't remember what region it's in. I think maybe it was in Celadon, so it was in Kanto. I found it. I went and looked to see if I could find it, and I did, and I found it for 2,000, so it was a great 8,000 drop in price. Now, we are to the gym. This is the gym. Now, most of the gyms look like this. Not all of them. And if you do this, I don't know why these are here, honestly. But they are. And you don't really have to do Sprout Tower stuff before you enter the gym. You can just go into the gym. That's all good. You do whatever you feel. So we're going to come up here. And I believe this gym is flying type Pokemon. Yeah? I may not be ready to battle this gym. I really may not. But we'll see. We'll give it a shot. So today we are reaching the gym. And after this, I'll show you the way to the start of Azalea Town, which is our second gym city. And that'll be tomorrow's episode. That'll be our next episode. Getting to and battling Azalea Town. And as you see, we are almost dead. And now me, personally, I don't know if I'm, coming back and forth, but we are going to go heal. And even in the games, even in the real games, like Pokemon Sun, I'm playing that right now, I'll go back and forth if I can. I'll heal and then go back in. It's a never-ending cycle until I get the high Pokemon, the high levels. And here we go, another one. Spearow. And we're going to Bubble Beam. That, see, we one-shotted it, just like I like, which is perfect. And some of you are probably asking, why did I do that with the first trainer? Well, honestly, didn't think about it. Just like that. Now we're going to heal before we battle Faulkner. And without my Fly Command, I do half full damage. And I'm not used to that, so I have to be careful with how I drop. Now we'll see if we can beat Faulkner. Now, may not be able to. I have no idea. We have, so far, Pidgey. A level 20, and we one-shot it in. Yay! Pidgey Johto. Not quite one-shot. I have a Skarmory. The bright side of having our Combustion is if we didn't beat it this time, we have Fire-type for the Steel-type. Now, we just won. Yay, we beat the trainer. And look, here is the Zephyr badge. Woot woot. We win. With Prinplup. Now, I know that this IV jump that I've done with the breeding is probably what just helped me here. It is not the level, it is not the move, it is the breeding. I do recommend breeding or, earning the money to buy bred Pokemon. Because it's just there. And breeding, it gives you something to do. Because oftentimes you might find that you don't have anything to do. Well, you're going to have to create things to do. Now, the one building I skipped before the gym is this. Over here, we have more trainers. We have Benny. Oh, we have an Oddish. And I'm not going to buy it. I like the move set so far. And we use Metal Claw. And a Paris. Now, eventually, I may or may not add at least one of my XP shares to one Pokemon, just so I can have it leveled at the same time. But we'll see. That might be a little cheap sellout right there. And it may not be per the rules of egglocke. That I have no idea about, but maybe I'll just stick with what we do. This is how I play. This is how I play in real games too. Level up one, and then go to the next. Until I get that XP share. And the reward from the grinding quest is an XP share, leftovers, maybe some money, but I think it's just the two. I don't know. Gravy kind of changes it sometimes. Sometimes he doesn't. And here's another trainer. And that is a one-spy trainer, so that's good. And look, here is our way to Azalea Town. Now, in the next video, we'll go there. And we'll explore. We'll show you the ruins of Alf. I think the ruins of Alf here. And over there you see those NPCs. Once you get through the maze, that's just, that's Team Rocket, is Jesse and James. And over here is trainers and Pokéloot for the ruins of Alf. And we'll show you that in our next video. And I think we're going to go back home. We're going to make an item frame real quick. Now we're going to stick our Zephyr badge right in it. We're going to make a little wall of badges somewhere in here. Somewhere around. Maybe we'll make it in our enchant room. Let's go back into my storage building, which you've seen in my first video. You've seen around my island before, so you know where I'm going. And we'll keep the stuff that I've gotten in here other than the badge. We'll keep the water stem. We'll keep the Pokeballs and the potions and the fish. Maybe we can do something with the fish later. Now, oh, I'm in the Pixelmon stuff. I'm not paying attention. So we need a piece of leather. One piece of leather, and we have it marked in our drops. Is he, no, wait. Oh, I don't have a piece of leather. Well, in this case, we'll buy one from the GY shop. But, you know, leather drops from mill tanks and Tauros. And we'll show you eventually where a good place to find mill tank and Tauros are. When we reach Gym 6 in Olivine City, and we'll show you that too. I'll show you. Because milk is going to be a good thing when you're doing scrolls, you know, food from the mill tank. It's all good. So where is our drop shop? There's a drop shop. And we're going to buy one. Oh, well, we'll buy one and confirm. And sticks. So I need, here, I have planks. I have sticks. And go up to a crafting table. Now, I hope you all know how to make an item frame, but if you don't, here it is. One leather in the middle, and six sticks around. Or eight sticks, I should say. And there's your item frame. I'll go find a place in our house to put it. And this will be our end of our video. If we can get out the door anytime soon. There we go. This will be our end of our video. Just placing this up after every video, we will place our new badge. And I will have some extra. I'll have the item frames already put up. And we'll go in here. Yeah? Does this seem like a good place? Or maybe our bedroom. Maybe our bedroom upstairs. And you know, I've showed you that too. If you have a better suggestion of where to put these, if you watch my first video, I would love the suggestion. Put it in the comments below and I'll take it. So here we go. Here is our first badge. There we go. Look, it's so pretty. Our Zephyr badge. And you know what? I have levels, so let's look at this. Since I don't need these, you didn't see inside them, but I have badges in my mall, or in my town, by my mall. And so we'll take and rename this one, just so it can't be used for anything else, really. It'll be an enchanted item, be renamed. I think we can rename it, and we'll rename it the same thing. We'll keep it a Zephyr badge. But we'll just make it so in the item frame you can see what it is. So I apologize for the extra thing, but I'm making it look a little nicer. And there's an anvil. And I know I'm probably to you people wasting the enchant levels, but as you see, it only costs 7. And if you mine enough, and you mine cool enough, as you see, I've probably been mining in between these videos. Then you have enough enchant levels. And as you get the donation ranks in one of the weekly kits, you get XP bottles too. You can get a lot of XP bottles once a week out of that, so you can have your levels pretty quickly if you donate. And yeah, if you're a miner and you have to ask your parents and they say no, well, then mining. Just mine coal and I think lapis and redstone, and then I'll give you all your XP. And battling the trainers and the NPCs and any Pokemon, you know, any Pokemon, it'll draw, it could give you XP too. So you have all ways of, you know, all that. So I think that's it for this episode. So we'll see you all again tomorrow. And we'll go for episode 2 of the Johto series. And MB, you know, and MamaBear plays Pixelmon. So thank you and goodbye. And if you like this video, hit the subscribe button for more and the like button if you like it. So good night, everyone, or good morning if you're, you know, in other states.